Hi, this is the Art Coffee Query. In this video, I want to show you how to make WebSocket running on live server. So you may have some projects required the WebSocket server to be running for notification purpose or for real-time chat system, okay? For this purpose, when we deploy our application on a live server, the WebSocket server is need to be running. Okay, yeah, let's just start. Okay, this is my Ubuntu server. I will use supervisor for this purpose. Okay, first of all, you need to install your supervisor. Sudo apt-get supervisor, okay. Sorry, apt-get install, okay. Yeah, I have already a installed supervisor. If you want to check, you can type sudo supervisor dash v or supervisor d. Yeah, if you want to check the version of installed supervisor, type supervisor d dash version, okay, -3.2.0. Once you have installed supervisor, then go to the root etc and supervisor. And check, yeah, and then cd conf.d. Okay, here inside conf.d, let me show, you need to create a file websocket.conf. Okay, by cd, sudo vim websocket. Yeah, I have already created this file. So after that, you need to this file should contain some configuration, okay. Yeah, so the file which is which you create should contain the file is program web sockets, okay. And the next line is command, which command you want to run. For me, it is php artisan web sockets serve. We want to run this this command, right? Yeah, for this for running this command, how we should write command is equal to usr and bin and then php. the whole this path is representing PHP. Instead of writing PHP, write the whole path usr ban php, okay? And then space where you want to run this command, and the remaining is artisan web sockets serve, okay? Where we should run this php artisan command inside our project, okay? Where the project is, where www.html and my application is shipback, okay? If you go to this path, yeah, here, this is my Laravel application, okay? So here I should type php artisan web sockets serve, okay? And what I should do, I will copy this one here, and set up and remove this one, okay? Yeah, this is artisan. And PHP, and this is artisan WebSocket serve. This was the second line, and the third line is the number of process is equal to 1, and auto start is equal to true, and then auto restart is also true, should be true, and the user is equal to the username. For me, it's ZIA. This is my username, okay? Yeah, that's all. You should copy and go to the file you had created, the file, the websockets.conf you had created, right? You should paste that right over to this file, right in this file, okay? And then after you have created this file with that content, instruct your supervisor to run that file. How do you do that? By sudo supervisor CTL update, okay? For me there is no new file configuration file to show here, but and then after this command you need to type sudo supervisor CTL start web sockets. Okay. Yeah, for me it says Websockets error already started. For you it will not show, okay? Yeah. And after that you should verify whether your supervisor, whether the supervisor running that file or not by typing sudo supervisor CTL status. Yeah. Websockets running process ID. It was difficult for me. I didn't know how to run. You can run any kind of program continuously in your server on your server using supervisor in this way. Okay. Yeah, thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to this channel and I will make more helpful